You are listening to Secrets of Divine Love Journal, Insightful Reflections That Inspire Hope and Revive Faith by A. Helwa. This audiobook is narrated by the author. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. In the name of Allah, the most merciful, the most compassionate. For the love of Allah and His prophets. Awakening to faith is not a one-time event, but a continuously unfolding reality. The journey of faith is not a race, but a marathon of love that each person walks at a different pace. Alhamdulillah. I am blown away by the love and generosity of Allah. He gives and gives and never needs a single thing in return. Everything Allah asks of us is not for Him, but for us. We do not pray, fast, or give charity because Allah needs it, but because our spirits need to be in the presence of the divine light to blossom. We are seeds. We are infinite potential hidden in the garden of a body, waiting to awaken through the mercy of Allah's light. All that is beautiful comes from the owner of beauty, Al-Jamal. Allah is hidden and apparent in the fragrance of all language and love. He is the reason we begin on the spiritual path. He is the reason we desire for something beyond what the senses can capture. He is the reason we set out to find ourselves and Him. It is Allah's guidance and your prayers, your divine supplications, that birth secrets of divine love, a spiritual journey into the heart of Islam, into existence. I am humbled by the kindness and grace of Allah. I'm especially humbled and speechless that Secrets of Divine Love has reached beyond prison walls into the hands of countless incarcerated men and women, some of whom are serving life sentences. Know that anything you have received through the heart of these writings was a product of Allah's kindness and grace alone. Each person that reached for this book reached for Allah. They didn't reach for this book because of me, but because they were looking for something they knew only the divine could give them. It is the words of Allah, the words of His prophets, and those who followed Him throughout time with sincerity and love that have inspired the reflections that I shared in Secrets of Divine Love. Your hearts have also inspired me in ways that are indescribable by words alone. The sincerity, the love, and the longing for Allah that I have witnessed through the readers of Secrets of Divine Love has left me both speechless and in tears. I do not take ownership over the love of Allah that called you to Him and the beauty of Allah that is so wonderfully reflected through the purity of your spirits. If I had eternal moments, I would love to listen to your stories over a cup of tea and pray together as one soul. I would embrace you with my whole heart and call you my friend, a companion on the path of love, from the creator of love to the destination of love. Although we can't escape the constraints of time and space, I pray this journal can mirror the conversation we would have if you and I could spend time together. In the following pages, we will contemplate the different chapters of Secrets of Divine Love, pray together, reflect on questions based on each chapter, and if Allah wills, step into a new dimension of faithfulness. This journal goes beyond Secrets of Divine Love and is curated with love to reflect deeply upon your relationship with Allah, His words, and His creation. You will be confronted, comforted, reminded, inspired, and if God wills, awakened to experiencing the faith you have always carried. I do not take ownership over the words I have shared, but I do feel grateful to be able to share such beautiful space with so many of you because of these words. Words to me have always been special, as they are vehicles of sound that meaning travels through between hearts. I know that time won't allow for me to be with each of you one-on-one, so with the help of Allah, I put this self-guided journal together to be your companion on the path of deep spiritual reflection. You can use this journal in a group, a book club, or for independent study. This journal is comprised of sessions which correspond with the chapter of the same name in Secrets of Divine Love. The intention being that after you read a chapter from Secrets of Divine Love, you can then refer to this journal to reflect and contemplate more deeply on the themes and concepts presented in the book. My prayer is that you never forget how much you are loved by Allah. I pray that you feel the light of His protection and mercy embrace you in every moment. I pray that this journal is a means of reminding you that no matter who you are or where you are from, Allah sees you fully, loves you unconditionally, and that the doors of His kingdom are open for you to return. As the mystics say, open your hidden eyes and come. Return to the root of your own self. Sending prayers of light upon light. Helwa. Love. It is the reason there is something instead of nothing. It is from the soil of love that all of existence blossoms into being. Love is why we are here. Introductory session. Truly those who have faith and do righteous deeds will the Most Gracious endow with love. Quran 19:96. Pre-session. Read the following sections from Secrets of Divine Love. Introduction and how to read from the heart. In every moment, Allah speaks of His love. Everything in and out of creation points to our loving Creator. His love is the reason why we were brought into existence. The gravity of His love makes life possible. He is the nucleus of all existence. He is the one that has no shape, yet holds all shape together. He is the beginning, middle, and end of love. He is before and beyond all love. He is always with you, with me, with all of His creation simultaneously. Allah's love and divine intimacy with us does not change, but our awareness of that love shifts due to the ever-changing states of our hearts and minds. In moments when our hearts are open, we see that the truth we have been searching so desperately for has always been right in front of us. The truth cannot always be understood, but it can always be felt. I witnessed this firsthand on my trip to the city of Cappadocia in Turkey. As I explained in the introduction of Secrets of Divine Love, in the section titled My Journey from Fear to Love. When the book first came out, readers always wanted to know more about this mysterious woman in Cappadocia that didn't just pray, but seemed to become a prayer and offered herself to God. When I noticed this woman praying in that 17th century animal barn, she was wearing a long, earth-colored kaftan with a white linen-like shirt underneath. It was almost as though her clothing stood as a representation of humanity. Her earth-colored kaftan worn like an outer clay body, while her white shirt beneath mirrored our beautiful spirits. In retrospect, I am amazed at how perfectly Allah orchestrated this dance of impermanence and eternity for me. The poetry of the moment fanned the flames of longing within me for a God I could feel, but did not yet know intimately. Explaining such a mystical moment through words is like trying to describe what an apple tastes like or what a rose smells like with language alone. As the 12th century poet Sana'i said, "External theological learning moves like a moon and fades when the sun of experience comes up. If words alone could give you what that moment gave me, I wouldn't stop writing. I would use all the ink in all my pens so that I could capture this moment and offer it to you from the depths of my heart. But words cannot capture what life gives so freely in between the lines. What I have come to realize is that Allah is always showing us these miraculous moments. We only call the things that we witness and amaze us as miracles or blessings, but that doesn't mean these moments are rare. Allah is generous."
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.